In this session, I'll be doing some worked examples that require consideration of internal resistance coming up. In this question, they're telling us that each cell has an EMF of 2 volts. So meaning that how many cells do we have here? We have 1, 2, 3 cells. So each of these has 2 volts. Each cell has an EMF of 2 volts and an internal resistance of 0.5 ohms. So each of these has an internal resistance 0.5 ohms each. What is the current flowing in the circuit? So now, of course, here the current flowing in the circuit, we know that current V is going to be equal to current I times R. But we know that this thing has got internal, there is EMF, and then there is what we call internal resistance. So the potential difference actually here in the whole circuit, the potential difference here is actually what we're calling the EMF. E is going to be equal to current flowing times R plus the internal resistance R. So now we want to find the current, so it's a matter of finding I, the subject of the formula. What's the EMF? Now looking at these cells, we have the EMF here of each cell is 2 volts, here it's 2 volts, here it's 2 volts. So when we add up this total EMF, these are cells in series, so it means 2 plus 2 plus 2, gives us 6 volts. So the total EMF there is going to be 6 volts, and we're able to add them up because the cells are in series. That's how we treat cells in series. 6 volts is going to be equal to the total current I times the effective resistance in the external circuit. Of course, the effective resistance in the external circuit is 5 ohms plus the internal resistance. Now these are 3 cells, and each of these cells has got an internal resistance of 0.5 ohms, and these cells are in series, so we are going to treat them again like they are resistors in series. And we know that resistors in series, their effective resistance is simply going to be a summation of them. So it means that the effective resistance R is going to be equal to 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 0.5, which is going to give us 1.5 ohms. So definitely our value of I there is going to be I times 6.5, giving us 6 volts. Of course, when we make our value of I the subject of the formula, we end up with 6 over 6.5, and we shall end up with our answer. Going on to our next question, they are still requiring us to find the current flowing in the circuit. Again, we shall say E is equal to I into R plus R. Our EMF, which is the potential difference in the whole circuit. Now, what is the total EMF? Now, in this question, we are being asked to find the current flowing in the circuit. Now, if you look at this circuit, it is having 2 cells. Now, these cells are in parallel. So now, if these cells are in parallel, what is, first of all, the EMF? Of course, because these cells are having potential EMF, 1.5 volts here, 1.5 volts there. And they both have internal resistance, 0.5 ohms. So using our formula, E is equal to I into R plus R. We need to first get the effective EMF. We need to first get the effective resistance and R. Now, if we're to look at it, EMF, we're having 2 cells. We're no longer having 1. It's 2 cells. So how do we get the effective EMF E of these 2 cells? The effective EMF there is going to be 1.5 volts. Take it as though you're dealing with resistors in parallel. In our previous example, you can see that we had these cells. They were in series with each other. And when they were in series with each other, to get the total EMF or the total potential difference across them, we had to add 2 volts plus 2 volts plus 2 volts, which is 6 volts, to get the effective EMF across them. And that is how we even deal with resistors that are in series. When resistors that are in series, to get the potential difference across all the 3 resistors that are in series, we just add the potential differences across each of those resistors. So it's the same way. Even when you look at this, these are cells in parallel. When you look at those cells in parallel, the potential difference across these cells in parallel is the same. So it means that the effective EMF here is going to be 1.5 volts. Then now when you look at the resistance here, These are the internal resistance here is 0.5 and the internal resistance here is also 0.5, and these two internal resistances are also in parallel. How do we deal with resistors in parallel? We know that for any resistor in parallel, to get the effective resistance, we know that 1 over R for this case is going to be equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. So these internal resistances, because they are in parallel, we are going to deal with them as in like we were dealing with resistors in parallel. So to get the effective resistance, R there is going to become 1 over R is going to be equal to 1 over 0.5 plus 1 over 0.5. You shall end up with 1 over R giving you 2 over 1. So in essence, R, no, this is actually 0.5. So R is going to be 0.5, divide that by 2, and that is in ohms. So we have our effective EMF and our R. So we'll come and substitute it right there. Of course, the effective resistance in the external circuit is 2 ohms. So when we come here, we shall say our EMF E, which is 1.5, is going to be equal to our value of I times capital R, which is 2 ohms, plus our effective R, which is 0.5 over 2. It's also in ohms. So we shall end up with our value of I times, our current is 0.67 amperes, current flowing through the circuit. You can try out that number for yourselves. Let me know what answer you get in.
This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to check out other excellent videos on the channel and don't forget to subscribe. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia helping you manifest excellence.